Minister, Minister Verlin Mead.
Give God some praise. Give God some praise in the house. He's worthy to be praised from the rising of the sun to the going down of the saints. Let's all bow our heads in prayer. Dear Father, we thank you, dear Lord, for your word today. We ask you, dear Lord, that I would decrease, but you would increase. We ask that your Holy Spirit would have its own way today. Minister, dear God, as never before, and we'll forever give you all the praise and all the honor and the glory. And the people of God say, amen. Come on, you may be seated in the presence of God. Giving honor to God, who is the head of my life. By him I live, by him I move, by him I have my being. Without him, I can do nothing, but I can do all things through Christ that give me strength. If you believe that, come on, give God some praise. And I'm reading today from the books of Genesis. Genesis chapter 32. Genesis chapter 32. Genesis 32, and I'm reading from verse 22. From verse 10 and 22. And it reads thus. And he rose up that night and took his two wives and his two women servants and his 11 sons and passed over the ford Jabbok. And he took them and sent them over the brook and sent over that he had. And Jacob was left alone. And there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And when he saw that that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go, except thou bless me. And he said unto him, what is thy name? And he said, Jacob. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince hast thou power with God and with men, and hast prevailed. And Jacob asked him and said, tell me, I pray thee, thy name. And he said, wherefore is it that thou askest after my name? And he blessed him there. And I would like to speak to you today on the topic, a new day is coming. A new day is coming. We don't know the future, but we know who holds the future. Amen. The future is in God's almighty hand. Yes, and we know once the future is in God's hands, you can rest assured that he's going to make everything all right for
Amen.
You.
Amen. Amen.
It was David who said that some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, some trust in their money, some trust in the stock, some trust in their job, but I will remember the name of the Lord.
Yes.
For the name of the Lord is a strong Yes. tower, Yes. and the righteous run into it, Yes. and they are safe.
Praise God. Praise
it's a new day.
Yes, Lord.
As we just read the scripture about a man called Jacob. Jacob was the brother of Esau. And Jacob did something to his brother that was very bad, in that he robbed his brother of his birthright. And because of this, he had to run away for his life, because he knew that his brother was going to kill him. His brother was very angry and mad at him. So for his safety, he had to run away. But the time came after many years that he said and decided, I'm going to go back home and make it right with my brother. I'm going to go back home and try to make peace where there is war. I'm going to try to make things straight where there are crooked. I'm going to try to make up with my brother. But on his way back home, he was very troubled. He was very stressed out. He was very perplexed because he did not know what was going to happen when he approached his brother. He did not know how his brother would receive him after all these years. Some people, they never forget what you did then. So he went on his way. He was very worried and troubled because he did not know what was going to happen when he get there. So the time came when he came to this area, and he sent everybody ahead of him. He said, you all go on a little bit. Go ahead, I'm coming. But it was night, and he decided, I'm going to stay here a little bit. But the Lord was looking at his situation. Amen. God did not turn his back against him. Amen. God remembered the promise that he made to Abraham. Yes. That I'm going to bless your seed as the stars of the sky and as the sand in the seashore, which is many. And God never go back on his promise. God never go back on his word. He always keep and will always keep his promise. So God remembered the word that he made to Abraham. And God saw that Jacob was very stressful and worried. Don't know what was going to happen when he approached his brother. And God, this night, while he was all alone, God sent an angel to his side. God sent an angel to rescue him. And the angel came by Jacob. But when Jacob realized that the angel was next to him, when he realized that he had good company, when he realized he had a heavenly visitor, he did not play slight. He took advantage of the presence of God. He said, listen, I was here all alone, but God showed up. I said, God showed up in my calamity. God showed up in my problem. God showed up in my situation. And he said, listen, I'm going to embrace this opportunity. The Bible said that Jacob held on to the angel. And he said, listen, I'm going to hold on with all my might. Because the Bible said that he wrestled with the angel. It was not an easy fight. It was not an easy thing to do because the angel has power. But Jacob said, listen, I'm going to hold on with all my might. I'm going to hold on with all my strength. I'm going to hold on. I'm going to hold on. I'm going to hold on all night. I'm here to tell somebody, it doesn't matter what you are going through. It doesn't matter how the situation looks. It doesn't matter how it may appear. I'm here. tell you, if you hold on to Jesus, if you hold on to his unchanging hand, I said, help is going to come. The Bible said that he wrestled with the angel. And you may ask me, how do you know that he held on to the angel? I knew he held on to the angel because the time came when day was about to break. And the angel knew that time was running out where I need to ascend back up to heaven. And the angel said, please, I'm trying to get away. I'm trying to get loose. I need you to let me go. I need you to release me. I need you to let me free me. But Jacob said, I will not let you go until you bless me. I'm here to tell somebody, I don't know what you're going through today, but I'm here to tell you, don't give up on your blessing. I'm here to tell you, he held on all night, but morning was coming. I'm here to tell you that if you hold on just a little bit longer, morning is coming. Our topic is a new day is about to break. Yesterday is gone. Yesterday is past. But I'm glad because it's a new day. It's a new season. It's a new time when God is going to do a new thing.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
When Jacob realized his situation, because he wrestled, the Bible said that he wrestled all night. Physically, I believe that he was tired. Physically, I believe that he was drained. Physically, I believe that he was worried a lot. But he said, listen, regardless to what it takes, I will never give up until I get what I need. The Bible said that during the wrestling, the angel realized that he's not giving up. Jacob is not backing down. Jacob would not take no for an answer. And I'm here to tell somebody, I don't know what you're going through today, but when God said yes, don't take no for an answer. While the wrestling was going on, while the battle was going on, when the angel realized that this man is not giving up, is not giving in, the Bible said that the angel put his hands in his hip, and the joint of his hip became loose. So now Jacob is not only weak, he's not only stressed out, now he's in pain because he lost his hip. But I'm here to tell you something. When God has a blessing for you, it doesn't matter what you lose. The blessing that God has for you is greater than what you have lost. I wish you could get some help. Jacob said, listen, I may have lost one hip, but what God has in store for me is greater than what I've lost. He said, I'm going to endure. I will endure the pain. I will endure the agony. Because I realize that if I get my blessing, the healing will come.
Amen.
If I get my blessing, restoration will come.
Amen.
If I get my blessing, my financial situation will change. Everything will change. Once I receive my blessing. Whatever you have lost during the battle, during your struggle, during your problems, I'm here to tell you that God has a greater blessing in store for you. I'm not worried about what I've lost in the past when I know that my Father has something greater in store for me. The reason why you lost that job, if you did not lose that job, you would not got the promotion where you are today. If you did not lose that job, you would not be able where you are today. Not only that, but I want you to realize the importance of the blessing. You might wonder why is it that when people have accomplished things, have gained things, have received things, it's not the same as when you get a blessing. The things of the world are material, are tangible. You can hold it with your hands. Thieves can come in and break and steal it away. But when God opened the windows, I said, when God opened the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing, pour out favor, pour out his anointing, I said, no man, no woman, no boy, no girl, no boss, no one can take it away from you. When God sent a blessing, it's eternal. Somebody need to give him some praise. An eternal blessing. I'm not going to satisfy with material things. I need God to pour out his anointing on my life.
Hallelujah.
Hey. When God sent his anointing, when he opened the windows of heaven and pour out his anointing on your life. People don't understand why you do what you do, why you live like you live, why you strive even though there's problems all around. But it's the anointing. I say it's the anointing. I say it's the anointing of the Holy Ghost that break yokes. It's the anointing of the Holy Ghost that destroy yokes. It's the anointing of the Holy Ghost that describes every day. The anointing. The anointing. Hey, somebody. I tell somebody, I don't know about you, but I prefer to have the blessings of God. I remember when we were young children growing up, our parents always tell us, don't worry about what you see your friends have, because you don't know how they get it. I wish I could get some help in here. You see your friends win a new car, but you don't know what they had to do to get it. You see them with the new shoes and new clothes, but you don't know what they had to do to get it. But they told us, listen, I may not have $1 million to give you. I may not have $1,000 to give you, but I'm going to make sure that I give you my blessing. I'm going to give you the blessings of the Lord. And the reason why I'm standing here before you is not because I am good. It's no goodness I have done. It's all because of the blessing of the Holy Ghost. It's the blessings of the Lord that added no sorrows. The blessings of the Lord is rich.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
I look at other young men my age, grew up in school with me. Some of them are in prison. Some of them, when the problems of life get to them, They lost their mind. They're in the mental institute someplace. But I'm telling you this, that the reason why I'm standing before you, clothed in my right mind, the reason why I'm standing before you, full of the Holy Ghost and power, is because of the anointing and the blessings of God. I said the blessings of God. I said the blessings of God. I said the blessings of Lord. It's keeping me. It's keeping me alive. I said it's keeping me from day to day. Thank God for his blessings.
Thank you, Jesus.
So Jacob realized the importance of the blessing. So Jacob said, listen, whatever you do, I'm telling you, I will never let you go until you bless me. And I'm here to remind someone. Some of us have been waiting for a while. Some of us have been holding on for a while. And it seems that the end will never come. But I'm here to tell you that the Lord is just sending a word to let you know that morning is about to break. I'm here to tell you that morning is coming. And the angel said, please let me go. Morning is coming. But Jacob said, I will let you go after you bless me. I'm here to tell you, don't give up on your blessing. Don't give up on your healing. Don't give up on that job. Some of us may not understand why we have to go through what we're going through. Not realizing that God is preparing you for greater things. God is preparing you for new things. Because Jacob realized, listen, today I'm worried. Today I'm stressed out. Today I don't know what to do. But I know once I get that blessing from the Lord, tomorrow is going to be a new day. Tomorrow is going to be a different day. Tomorrow I'm going to shine like the bright and burning star. Tomorrow I'm going to be a brand new person. When I go and talk to my friends, I'm going to have a different countenance. I'm going to have a different attitude. I'm going to have a different personality. I wish I could get some help in here. I'm telling you that tomorrow I'm a different person.
Thank you, Lord. Praise God.
Your friends and your co-workers don't understand. Why is it that even they know that you are going through things, that you still have a song, you still have a smile? Not only that, but they realize from the time that they hired you on the staff that things are different. Because God will bless the company that you work with just for your sake. I wish I could get some help up in here. Hey! Your company was about to go bankrupt. They were about to close down. They were about to shut down. But when God, came in the company, and use you as a representative. Hey, somebody, when you stepped in that office and the manager realized that since they hired you, that things are different. From the time that you came on board, from the time that you became a part of the staff, things are different. Now they are getting contracts from east, west, north, and south. Business is booming. Getting better, all because of you. I'm talking about the favor. I said the favor. I said the favor. I said the favor of Almighty God is upon you.
Hallelujah.
That's why Jacob said, listen. Jacob said, listen. I don't care what you do. I need the blessing. realize who you are and whose you are, you cannot take it lightly. When people at work see you and they come up to you and they say, "Verlin, I need you to pray for me. Yesterday was the last time that I was able to minister to someone going through problems. And someone also told me that their mother, they need to take them to a psychiatrist because they realize something is not right with her." I told the listener, "I don't know much about the psychiatrist, but I know somebody better than a psychiatrist." I told them, "Listen, prayer works." And I told them, "Listen, if you can only get your mother to pray with us and let us approach the throne of God on her behalf, she would not need to see no psychiatrist. She would not need to see no one else because God is going to operate." I said, "God is going to show up." I said, "God is going to do something in her life and change things around." I'm talking about the power and the blessing of the anointing God. Jacob said, "Listen, I need the blessing." And the angel said, "Listen, I am going to go. I'm going to let you go because day is breaking. But before I let you go, I want you to ask you, what is your name?" Jacob said, "My name is Jacob." But you have to understand that meant a whole lot. Because Jacob, when you refer to Jacob, all who knew Jacob, they knew him as a thief. They knew him as a trickster. They knew him as someone that you cannot trust. So the angel said, "Listen, I knew that your name was Jacob yesterday, but from today, from this moment, you're going to have a different name. When God comes into your life, things change. Your personality change. Your attitude change. You are a brand new person. Now, you are no more a Jacob, but you shall be called Israel." And let me tell you a little bit about Israel. Hold on just a little bit, a moment there. Can I tell you a little bit about Israel? Israel means triumph with God. Israel means the God that prevails. Because Jacob was the omen, the bad guy, the guy with a bad attitude. But now that Israel comes on the scene, he's now representing the God of Abraham. Amen. Now Israel can come into any office and say, "Listen, I am Mr. Israel, the representative of God's people. I'm here to tell you, when God changed your name, when he changed your nature, now you can go into any office and say, 'Listen, I'm a child of Almighty God. I don't know who you met the other day, but I am a different person because I met the Master. I met Jesus and he changed my life. He changed my attitude. He changed my personality. I'm a brand new man." Now, he's Israel, the representative of God's people. And if you knew the history, from Jacob came all the way down the lineage, then you came forth Jesus. from the lineage of Jacob. So God changed the whole history of his life. If he did not meet that angel, if he did not get that blessing, we don't know what would have happened to his future. But once you meet God, once you had that encounter with God, you have to realize you have a bright future. Prosperous future. God is telling his people today, when I come into your life, things are going to be different. Things are going to change. Because I am God and there is none beside me. And now you have the children of Israel. And if you know the history about Israel, right now, Israel is not a big nation, but Israel is a blessed nation.
Amen.
You have to understand that even right now, there are other nations and other countries trying to destroy Israel, trying to wipe Israel off the map. But I'm here to tell them they are fighting a losing battle. I'm here to tell them that they are fighting a losing battle. It doesn't matter what they come up against Israel with. That's God's chosen people.
Amen.
And you cannot touch them.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm here to tell you, whatever God has promised, he's able to bring it to pass.
Yes.
It's a new day. It's a new season.
Yes.
It's a new time. When God said, I am going to show up. But I want you to know something today. Don't you ever give up on your blessing. Don't you give up on what God has in store for you. Because if Jacob had only given up, if he had only given to the pain, to the agony, to the suffering, he would have lost everything. But because he held on, because he fight with all his might. I'm here to tell you, hold on, hold on, hold on, regardless of how tough things get. Because I know that if you only hold on just a little bit longer, a new day is coming. And my word for one accord today, from the pastor coming right down, that this is just a changing of the season.
Amen.
This is just a changing of time, because God is in the midst of this people. And I'm here to tell you that with all that's going on around us, if we only keep focus and keep our eyes on Jesus, that he has bright future, a bright future in store for his people. Stand on your feet. Stand on your feet today. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm here to tell you today that God is in the midst of his people. I want everybody to please come. Everybody please come, because it's a new day. Everybody come, it's a new season. It's a new time, and God is going to pour out his spirit upon his people. This is no time for joke. Jacob was not playing around. He was serious, because he realized, this is my time. I cannot afford to let this time and opportunity pass by, because I'm not sure of another time. Today is our day. Today is our day. For a miracle, for an outpouring of God's Holy Spirit. Come on, Pastor. Hallelujah. Come on, give him some praise.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Come on, give him some praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Shall we all raise our hands to our Heavenly Father? in the name of Jesus.